Well, the music industry's best and brightest celebrated in New York City last night for the 60th annual Grammy Awards. Sunday's show at Madison Square Garden was filled with musical moments to remember, including Elton John's performance with Miley Cyrus. Being part of last night's special wasn't cheap. CBS charged up to $1 million for a 30-second spot in the Grammy Awards this year. And Target and IBM are some of the advertisers that reportedly paid that amount for those commercial spots. IBM also curated videos and photos on social media during the red carpet pre-show event. In 2017, 27.6 million viewers watched the Grammy Awards on CBS. Henna Dobie takes us behind the scenes from last night.
The Grammys were as much about the actual awards as they were about social and political issues. On the awards front, there was no bigger winner than Bruno Mars. He won all six awards he was up for, including Song of the Year, Record of the Year, and Album of the Year for 24 Karat Magic.
Those songs were written with nothing but joy.
Kendrick Lamar wasn't far behind with five wins. And Alessia Cara, who won Best New Artist, was among those wearing a white rose to raise awareness for the Me Too and Time's Up movements.
I hope you find your peace.
Kesha, backed up by several top female artists, dedicated a moving rendition of her hit Praying to women who are survivors of assault. And a country music quartet performed Eric Clapton's Tears in Heaven in honor of those killed in two attacks on musical events last year, the shooting at a Las Vegas music festival and the bombing at an Ariana Grande concert in Manchester, England.
If I saw you in heaven.
So we watched the show last night, and I mean, it was a a variety of different things, which I was kind of intrigued by because, and you know, I haven't really sat and watched the Grammys like that in a long time. So, but there were some fun things. I was sitting there watching one performer come on, and I looked at him like, hey, Ann, isn't that the guy from the show Community? And I'm like,
and Atlanta.
Well, I don't know the Atlanta. I know what Atlanta is, but I'm like, isn't that the guy? And Ann's like, no, that's not him.
I said that at first.
And
I
then
said,
sure enough, it is him.
No, I said, that's Childish Gambino.
Yeah, Childish Gambino, but it's Donald Glover.
I knew
Glover,
that, but I didn't know that was his alter ego.
I had no clue that he did this. I mean, this guy's super talented.
This guy's like a Renaissance man.
Yeah.
He does a little bit of everything, and he sang, and it sounded to me,
he was really
it was like
good.
Marvin Gaye.
It was a Marvin Gaye type of
deal. It was pretty great.
Yeah. So, but I liked... I liked DJ Khaled and Rihanna. That was probably my favorite performance.
There was some action on the stage going on during that performance.
There was a lot.
Rihanna was like.
And then I was kind of bummed out about, even though Bruno Mars kind of went back to the 90s with this thing, I wasn't too pumped up. I was hoping he'd sing 24K because I love that song. But
But his album did win.
I know,
24K.
He did win a bunch of awards. But
is there anybody who does, like, he dances and he sings?
No, he's super talented.
He's been on the stage since he was, like, you know, 2 years old.
But then the fun stuff, too, with, you know, Elton John. And a lot of those things. And, you know, our favorite
Lady
moment
Lady Gaga and Kesha.
The Kesha thing was good, yeah. But we always pay attention to the things that we always pay attention to the memorial segments, no matter what award show is out there. It's like, who passed and how do they honor them? And so we just always pay attention to that when we watch those
things. It's interesting. That must be the most challenging segment of the evening when you try to get all of those people, and you know that they have to leave some people out. But then how many do you use their voices on, and how many do you include? Just, they did the rap, the people did the rap, and the R&B people kind of together, and had like one.
Yeah, but I was bummed out that, you know, Hugh Masekela died last week, and we were talking about that.
Grazing in the Grass.
Right, so I had that song in Kayla's head all last week. And so I was hoping they'd play that again just for Kayla.
Oh, it's an amazing song, timeless. And I loved the Broadway section.
Ah, yes.
And Ben
Platt.
Ben Platt sang
the Pitch Perfect
somewhere
guy. That's how
from West Side Story. And it, like, broke my heart. Every time I hear that song, I just cry because I love.
She was in tears.
Leonard Bernstein and
just so you know.
West Side Story. And Patti LuPone.
She was good, too.
She's a legend.
So, but it was fun to watch it last night. I was actually kind of taken by it, so
it was good. 3.5 hours. That's a commitment.
That's a long time.
That's a commitment. So, yeah. Better be good.
Yeah, anyway. Well, we've got a lot more coming up on KELOLAND Living.
Anyway.
Yeah, so don't go away. We'll be right back.